The actual fact is there are a lot of startups in Ethiopia working in ride sharing, agri-tech, health tech, platform to connect low-skill jobs with employers using technology of GPS in mobile applications. So the ocean is coming.
I want to show to the world that Ethiopians can be successful through the technology sector. I want to prove that point.
As you can see behind me, Addis Ababa, the capital of Ethiopia, is a city undergoing a massive transformation. There are construction sites and cranes literally scattered around the city. Don't want to believe
it. There's a big difference since 4 years to now. There has been a significant change, both in terms of technology, infrastructure, better stability. Access to technology has been much more. There's been palpable difference.
When I speak, hey guys, we are doing machine learning, deep learning, neural nets, and we have a customer from Honda, we have a customer from Canada, from Silicon Valley, from Hong Kong. Nobody believes that this type of talent can exist in Africa at all. They are just looking at Africa as in the old era.
They usually judge us, we are poor, but when you actually come here, there's a lot of energy, a lot of ideas, and yes, there's a lot of problems, but problems are an opportunity for entrepreneurs to do something new.
So today, you know, when I say jokes with you, you know, everyone I talk to, you're the superstar. You're the Elon Musk of Ethiopia. When did you figure out that providing people with safe transportation was an option and that you were going to be able to make something of that?
When we launched it, the day I launched it, I called to one of the journalists saying, there is a system called Ride, and it connects the passenger with the driver. It works with SMS. You can text with this four-digit number. It will contact you. I explained it to him. He said, oh, it's like Uber. I said, what is Uber?
When I walked in here, and when I look at kind of what's behind us and what people are working on here, this could be anywhere in the world. Do you think that ultimately there's any difference between, you know, you and your equivalent in Canada or in the US or anywhere in the world?
I don't think so. It's the power of the internet, the power of the World Wide Web, is you can get access to anything if you have a computer and the internet. It's just a matter of educating yourself. And that's why I focus on teaching young people on coding and robotics, because the first essential thing to actually go to that innovation and what makes any country different from Ethiopia is their education system. Exposing people to these technologies is very important. I might even think some people might be better because of the hardships and the problems that people might have here while getting into the innovation.
This is what I want people to hear, because what you've just described proves that it doesn't matter where you are in the world, entrepreneurs are entrepreneurs. Think about innovation, we tend to think about places that look like this. Yet in Addis and a host of other unconventional places for innovation and technology, old perspectives are giving way thanks to a new generation of innovator and entrepreneur who's intent on changing their world and ours. From Jakarta to Bucharest, from Santiago to Cartagena, I'm Dan Herman, and this is Their World, Our Future.